Holy smokers, guys. Warren Buffett is in love with the Apple. He is just loaded up on more Apple shares, okay? So basically, he increased his holdings by 23.3%. This news just came out. Now he owns 165 million shares as of this filing that just came out here. Now he may still be buying more. I think he is buying more. And we're going to kind of discuss like why this is his number one really stock pick because of the amount of money he's putting into it. Now, he's probably not just looking at it from his perspective. He's probably talking to Todd and Ted, the two guys that are supposed to take over for Warren Buffett whenever he passes away or whenever he just retires. He's 87 years old now. Obviously, he can't be there forever. So I'm sure he's getting input from those guys. But we're going to discuss this on why he is buying shares like crazy in this stock. If Warren Buffett's buying shares like crazy, he's obviously got to believe in this company a lot. And we know Warren Buffett, he usually makes the majority of his jump shots, right? He usually makes them. So is Apple really like the easiest money to be made out there right now? Well, let's view Apple for a second and let's really talk about what Warren Buffett sees in this company and why he's buying shares. Because remember, you know, he could be doing anything with that money. He could be putting that money in Google. He could be putting it on Amazon. He could be, you know, buying smaller type companies. He could be doing whatever he wants with that money. And he's putting that money in Apple stock. It's his number one holding he's really adding right now. And I think it's gonna end up being his number one biggest position out of all his positions actually, guys, which is crazy, especially considering this is a stock he just started adding about a year, year and a half ago. He started adding these shares when they were in the high 90, like low 100 range. So he's already up big on them. So first thing is, he sees a big company with Apple. He needs to really invest in huge corporations. Apple's the biggest in the world as far as public companies go, right? He needs a big corporation to invest in, okay? But he also sees, he sees Coca-Cola in this company. How does he see Coca-Cola? Well, in consumer tech, there are two guys running the whole game in consumer technology, okay? One is Apple. Apple represents Coca-Cola, okay? They represent Coca-Cola. If you don't know, Warren Buffett's the biggest investor in Coca-Cola. He was buying those shares like crazy back in the 1980s, added throughout the 80s, and then he's basically just held his position ever since. It's a multi-billion dollar position of his, okay? So he sees Apple as the Coca-Cola of consumer technology, okay? With Samsung being the Pepsi of, the whole game there. So he sees this space where Apple's a Coca-Cola, Samsung's a Pepsi, and every single other company in consumer tech is like whatever. Like they're all just a bunch of whatevers. They're very insignificant. They're like the RC Colas of the world and whatnot. There are two guys running the whole game in consumer technology, and then there's everyone else way back and behind there, guys. So that's the way he's viewing it. So he says, okay, these guys have a premier brand as Coca-Cola did. They have great distribution, retail stores and all those type of things. He says, okay, they have consistent products, okay? We know the iPhone, sales numbers, they pretty much just go up every single year. And now they might be slowing as far as the rate that they are gonna go up and things like that, but it's consistent. Someone's iPhone breaks, tomorrow, they go buy another iPhone, okay? Same thing if somebody's Samsung phone broke tomorrow, like they're gonna go buy another Samsung phone. That's just the way it is. It's consistent revenue streams. Somebody's computer goes down, they go buy a new Mac, okay? Somebody's iPad breaks, they go buy another iPad. That's just a recurring revenue stream that they've got there, okay? Then on top of that, he sees the services business, okay? He sees the services business there, which is a huge business that has grown massively, right? And a straight profit machine for Apple. All those apps that people buy, right? Apple Music, you know, possibly they might have a Netflix type service coming on sooner or later here. Cloud storage. There's so many different things. Never mind the repairs and all those type of things, guys. There's so much that goes into it on the services side of the business, which has grown massively. And it's a recurring revenue stream, a massive one that's probably gonna end up being the biggest revenue stream and profit machine for Apple going forward, probably within a 5-year span, because it's going to become that big of a part of a business, okay? He also sees a company that pays a dividend and is very committed to paying a dividend 4 times a year and upping that dividend, okay? He also sees a company that is buying back shares in a huge way right now, which is basically going to make that EPS look better and better as the years go on, as long as their net income can stay consistent or go up, which it should go up over time, right? He sees a company that's buying back shares on a mass scale, which basically brings down their PE ratio, which brings me the PE ratio. He sees a company that has a forward PE on this company of somewhere around 12 right now. A forward PE is somewhere around 12. So you're going to tell me he's going to look at all this and he's going to say, this is a great deal for us, okay? Now, you might ask, well, you know, he's buying Apple shares. He's been buying Apple shares for the last year or two. Why has he all of a sudden gotten an Apple? Why didn't he get an Apple 10 years ago? Why didn't he get an Apple 20 years ago? Apple was a different company at those times, okay? You could say, well, maybe you could have seen all this coming. Maybe you could have, and some investors did. But Warren Buffett, he likes to buy companies that are already proven, okay, that have already proven they can do it and then are expected to do it in the future, okay? Apple has proven this now. They've proven their business model in going forward. 10 years ago, okay, 2008, and most people didn't know iPhone would be as big as it is, okay? Most people didn't know services is going to be this huge, giant category that if that was a broken out company, it'd be one of the biggest companies in the world. Like, people didn't see that iPad wasn't even out at that time. Like, the business was fundamentally very, very different, okay? It was a very, very different business. They had not proven themselves yet, okay? Warren Buffett likes companies that have proven themselves. At this point in time, Apple is a very proven company. They got all these things going for them. They pay a dividend. They're committed to that. They're buying back shares on a massive scale, and they will probably be upping that buyback, which will basically just mean their EPS goes up and up and up because there's less shares to count against the net income, guys. And they see a premier brand, the Coca-Cola of consumer electronics, and they really only see one main threat out there, the Pepsi of it, and that's Samsung, and everybody else is so far behind the ball. Everybody else is so far behind the ball that it's like they almost don't even matter out there, guys. So when he looks at this company, he's like, this is a company that is going to probably double, triple my money over the next 5-10 years, and that's what he's going for, okay? That's a great return for Warren Buffett, or pretty much for any investor. He's like, this is easy money, this is money in the bag, and that's just the way he's kind of viewing it, and I will say he's probably going to make very good on this. And Warren Buffett and my wife, they're also buying shares. My wife's been buying Apple shares the last couple of weeks pretty heavily, and Warren Buffett is too, and he will probably continue to, and I won't be surprised if that becomes his number one biggest position in his entire portfolio, guys, for that very reason. It's a simple investment. There's nothing complicated about it here. Nothing complicated about this. Simple investment. It's what Warren Buffett likes. Understand the categories. Understand where growth is going, all those type of things. Apple just did $20 billion in profit in a three-month span. Their last quarter, they just reported, they did $20 billion in a three-month span. Profit. Profit. Not revenue. Profit. That's ridiculous, guys. That's absolutely ridiculous, and it's just going to probably get better and better for them as time goes on. So anyways, let me know what you think about this. Do you think Warren Buffett's making a smart move and adding more and more of these shares and maybe making it his number one position over the next year or two? Do you think it's a bad move? Do you think there's another company he should be in or something? I would love to know your guys' opinion on all this. Thank you for watching, as always, and have a great day.